I give you praise, honor, and glory. I thank you for you always take me to destination. Heaven is my home. And even here, let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. I give you praise. We bless this country. We bless Israel. We bless all nations. We bless you. We thank you. We give you praise, honor, and glory for eternal life. We are saved, healed, delivered, set free. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Redeemed of the Lord. Say so. I want to tell you that, man, there is nothing like walking in greater revelation of who you are in Christ. The scripture in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, you know, that says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus. The moment that we are in him, we can give thanks, because in him, all his promises are yes and amen. I want to read a passage. Oh, God. Oh, is that where we're going, Holy Spirit? Well, then, let's go. Glory.
Hallelujah.
So let's go to 1 Peter. It's right before the second one. No, actually, I think it's in John. I have to flow with the Holy Spirit. I don't have a mark there. Okay, 1 John. It's after Peter, because Peter was more important. I'm just kidding. It's 1 Peter, 2 Peter, then you make a right, and here is 1 John. And in chapter 5, wow. 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 Makes you want to start at Genesis 1 and go the way to Revelation. Right? Well, since we're in the neighborhood, let's... Look, verse 4 says, for whatever is born of God... How many born of God? Oh, I get the right church. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world of faith. Who is he who overcomes the world but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? And then we read in verse 13, these things I have written to you who believe in the name of the Son, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may continue to believe in the name of the Son of God. And I want to take some big zooming lenses, and I want to zoom in on verse 14 and 15. Now this is the confidence that we have in him. That if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. Now, I don't know if you've ever had a conversation with someone and you just felt like you were on two different tracks. I don't know if that ever happened to you, that you just felt like you were two trains, not only on two different tracks, but that it may have appeared that you were going in two different destinations, totally opposite of one another. The parable of the sower teaches us that the enemy, the world, even our own flesh, there's a battle that comes to steal the word. Because there's power the moment that we receive the word, we hear it, we have to hear the word. And then we have to continue in the word that we hear. Because as we have received him, we walk in him. I'm amazed on the incredible understanding that our Father hears us. Because when it comes to him, because we are in Christ Jesus, he hears even when we don't speak. He knows our heart. He hears our heart. He hears our groaning. He hears everything that comes from us. He's a loving Father. Just like if you have children and you remember when they were babies and they couldn't talk. They couldn't talk. Because out of our heart, the mouth speaks. Sometimes we only talk about our words of faith. You know, speak faith, says the right thing. Well, excusez-moi. But my Father hears when I don't know how to put in words. My Father hears me when I don't know what to say. My Father hears me when our heart breaks. My Father hears me when I groan. My Father always hears me the same way that a natural father, as soon or a parent or a mother, and they hear the baby and nobody else knows what the baby needs. They don't even need one of those machines in the crib. See, we have the Holy Spirit in our crib. Father hears us. He says, the moment that you pray according to his will, Father, help me. Help me, Father. Help me love. Help me love like you love. I hear you. Father, help me forgive them. I hear you. Not with a hearing that just hears, but a hearing that listens, that pay attention. And there is nothing more pleasing to our Father than when he hears you in your heart with everything that you are. He believe and stand for what you can have because of what Christ has done. There is nothing more pleasing unto him, because not only he hears you, but he listens and he pays attention. And you have that petition. Because God works in eternity. It doesn't matter what you're working and looking at now. That's why here in the scripture it says, and if you know that you have eternal life, because he said, if you don't know that you have eternal life, if you don't know that you know that you know that you know, then everything else you will question one day or another. So if you don't know that you have eternal life, I often think about people that go home that go home, but they might never had the opportunity to say with their voices whatever their heart has received. I believe in a God of mercy that hear what we cannot speak. I believe in my Father. And not only I believe in him, but I believe that there's some people that might say things, but it doesn't mean nothing. Because God looks at the heart. Once you believe in him and you believe in eternal life, then your Father, my God, every time you grow into understanding of what his will is, that you grow into the knowledge of who he is, he delights to hear you in your heart. Stand in your faith of who he is, even when you don't see any results. Stand into who you know your God to be, because all that matters to you is that he's the way, the truth, and the life. He says, and if you know that I hear you, yeah. I hear you. I remember when my kids, or even now spiritual kids, when people say things that's opposite to God's will, I often says, oh, I didn't hear that. I don't want to come in agreement with what I just heard you. If it's something that's just is the opposite of what I know was done on the cross. No, I didn't hear that. I didn't hear that. And yes, Holy Spirit. There's one passage in John. It's the same John. There is not one John and then another John that's First John and then another John that's number two. And then another one that's number three. But go to John, the same John. Oh, God. Oh, I feel the presence of the Lord. I want to talk a little bit about hearing. And yes, Lord, in John chapter 11. Whoo, Jesus. My God. It says in verse 4, well, I guess we better go in verse 3 since we're in the neighborhood. It says, therefore, the sisters sent to him, to Jesus, because, you know, Lazarus was sick. And it says, Lord, behold, him who you love is sick. And when Jesus heard that, oh, God. When Jesus heard that. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through it. And then when you put your signal and you make another right and you get to verse 38, it says, then Jesus again, groaning in himself, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay against it. And Jesus said, take away the stone. And Martha, the sister of him who was dead, said to him, Lord, by this time there is a stench, for he has been dead 4 days. And Jesus said to her, did I not say to you that if you would believe, you would see the glory of God? Now I want you to listen to this word in connection to eternal life. Because some people can be resuscitated. But not resurrected. All right, get the right church, I go back. Even though I believe in healing and resuscitation. Amen. But if you don't know that you've been risen with him, that you have resurrection life, that you have eternal life, then you won't know how to walk in the promises of God. You have to know who you are in the Spirit so that by the Spirit you can walk in authority over the things of the world so you can overcome the world, the flesh, and the enemy. But this is what I wanted to look at. It says, And then they took away the stone from the place where the dead man was lying. And then Jesus lifted up his eyes and he said, okay, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. And I know that you always hear me. But because of the people who are standing by, I said this, that they may believe that you sent me. There's some people around you. My God. There's some people around you that when God has you speak forth what you believe in the name of Jesus, in the midst of your circumstances, in the midst of everything that you go through, there's some other people that what's important for you to speak forth what you know and have heard, it's for them. So Jesus hears the bad report. But instead of hearing that at the same time, he's always listening to what Father's will is. And suddenly he realized that this is going to be to demonstrate the resurrection and the life. So suddenly, instead of coming right away, he holed off so that he can get there after the 3 days. Because if somebody is resuscitated within 3 days, then they can justify it. So he shows up on the 4th day. He walks in a way that other people can know that Father has sent him, because he doesn't want them to declare him to be powerful, him to be a great prophet, him to be somebody that he's not. He wants them to know. Wow. Every time you do anything in the name of Jesus, you can know that you know that you know that you are declaring that your Father has sent you, that you come in the name of Jesus. Every time you speak forth and you walk in an understanding that your Father hears you all the time, because you in Christ Jesus. Now there's some times that Father says, no, I didn't hear that. Now there's some times, according to the word, that it even says the husband to honor their wives and to have peace at home, because otherwise your prayers are hindered. Oh, we better keep that for Father's Day. There's another passage in Luke that Jesus, he said, I thank you, Father, that you have revealed this unto babes. It's important to see when Jesus is thankful to Father. Because he knows that when you have a revelation of your Father and you know that he hears you, then you can stand. You can stand, because even I remember when my mom went home to be with the Lord, I knew she was just asleep. I knew to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And I just knew. I just knew. And to me, I started understanding that if I really believe in eternal life, then his promises that he will meet all of my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus, I can stand on even when I'm broke. Then by your stripes I am healed. I can walk even if my body has pain. There's just symptoms, lying symptoms. I know that it's just a matter of time before I walk in total healing. I know when I have fear in the midst of the storm. I know where you have not given me a spirit of fear. I know that my Father hears me. Every time that you declare, my Father, he will meet all of my needs, it's the moment that you declare, my Father, give me peace, 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 peace you gave to me. Not as the world gave, did you give to me. Your peace you gave to me. I thank you. Your Father not only hears you, but it says if you know that he hears you, you have the petition. Because that very moment, he moves. And it's not really that he gives you what's not there. Is that you stop hearing. You stop hearing what you shouldn't be listening to. You stop hearing voices that are between you and your Father that you have to remove out of the way. You stop hearing your own voice, your own mind, your own thought. You stop hearing faithless people who might not know about eternal life. You stop hearing things that's trying to come between you and your faith that he hears you. You stop hearing even some lies that can come to you that maybe what you're going through is because you didn't have enough faith. Your faith is not what you have faith in. Your faith is in Jesus Christ, your Lord. You are in him. Glory, hallelujah. You are in him the moment that you are born again. I love the way Jesus... oh, yes, Lord. There's what we hear and we shouldn't hear. Then there's other people, they're hearing. What is Jesus gonna do? Mary and Martha both told him, if you would have been here, our brother wouldn't have died. But yet, even though they could have been disappointed, they were thinking, well, now he's here. So everything is possible. Even though you might have been disappointed a few chapters before. Even God doesn't just hear what you believe. He hears your disappointments. He hears your cries. He hears your hurts. He knows sometimes because you believe that you wonder why something hasn't manifested yet. Not because you don't believe, but because you do. Father hears. And he weeps. He took your infirmities. He makes intercession for you. He knows exactly what you're going through. And he hears and he wants you to know. It might not seem to you that I'm working on anything, but one day when you're going to see it all, the same way that he said it was so that he would be glorified. See, the sickness doesn't glorify God. He said, one day, well, you're going to see. You're going to see everything. And I'm not talking about one day on the bye-bye. When we look back in our lives, I don't know about you, but I can be like Jesus said, I thank you that you have heard me. And because I look back in the past and I thank you, God, that you heard me when I didn't even know what to say. I thank you, my God, that you heard me, that you worked things around for the good. I thank you, my God, that you worked in my life, that what came to break me, you used to make me a vessel of glory. I thank you, my God, that everything the enemy has done to our children, just like you do, you just worked it, that one day, God, everybody will know, every knee will bow, everyone will know, my God, you have a way, my, you have a way. Our God will be glorified like never before. Everything will be to the glory of God. My. I rejoice to see what the Lord has done. He said, I know that you have heard me, and I know that you always hear me. I'm not having a conversation between you and me just to stir myself up. I need them to know that what's about to happen, my God, is so that they know you, that they know you. I don't know what happened in your life, but when I think about what the Lord has done in my life, in the life of people that I know, I see His glory. The way that you're able to still be here standing, believing in eternal life, I see the glory of the Lord. I see the glory of the Lord when someone walks in His promises. I see the glory of the Lord when someone might not be appeared to walk in the promises, but they believe and they stand. And they cry out to their Father. And their Father, He said, abide in me. My words abide in you. Says, whatever you desire will be done unto you. There's something about abiding in His word, about hearing his word and continuing in that, in standing on His word, on everything that He has promised. Now you see, Mary and Martha, they hear Him say that. And all the Jews and all the people that were there, they all hear Him say that. Father has sent me. My Father, I know you always hear me. Now remember, this is the Son of Man. You always hear me. You always hear me. So then, oh God, then somebody else He was going to talk to that was going to hear Him. Then the stone is rolled away. And He says, Lazarus. It says, come forth. Not only others heard Him. Not only God heard Him, Mary heard Him, Martha heard Him, but glory, hallelujah, the way that Lazarus heard Him. He heard Him. He came out. When it's time for somebody to be born again, when it's time for Lazarus to come forth, He had told Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. She said, well, I know one day we only say, no, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, my God, even though he will die, he will live. He said, do you believe this? Do you believe this? Said, do you believe this? My God. Lazarus, come forth. The moment you don't know what the Holy Spirit. Whoo! The Spirit of faith, the Spirit of life, the Spirit of glory. He's about to remove veils. He's about to speak forth to people that people don't even know. Well, Lazarus didn't speak faith. No, Lazarus was under the ground. But he heard. Because what I love about my God is even though when I'm not all that and I don't know how to hear, because my hearing is filtered through pain of the past, through woundings, through things that my hearing might be distorted. Your hearing might be hindered because of something in your body and you're not able to hear. I call it the bypass anointing. I call it the way that God is able to reach forth behind what you cannot do because He's not depending on you. His faith is not on you. His faith is in what He has done, and the work that He has done is so done that He has the ability to break forth and make sure, my God, that He hears you and you hear Him. Now there's a whole lot of things today that I'm going to speak forth, that I believe that it's time for our children, grandchildren, to be loosed.
There's a lot of things that I'm going to speak forth this morning. Hallelujah. That I believe that my God hears us. I believe this morning that there's a lot of things that the enemy has been trying to kill, steal, and destroy the next generation. But can I tell you, that I believe that Father hears us today. I believe today in one accord that we pray, we believe, that we make our request known unto him with prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. And I believe that the enemy will not have our children. The enemy will not have our grandchildren. I believe that God is going to be able to make them hear. Make them hear. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I declare an eviction to the dumb and deaf spirit. I proclaim every ear to be open. I release an anointing for God to break through our humanity that many are going to hear. I even declare unto you that some prodigals are coming back home. Prodigals are coming back home. Hallelujah. I declare upon their life, because you know, my God, the enemy is always coming against our seed because of the battle against the seed of the woman. My God, God is raising up a generation. He said bringing us into sonship. So the enemy, for a generation, he came with abortion, he came with drug abuse, he came with wrong sexual twisted things, he came with a whole bunch of things to kill our children. But today, I want to speak from here and declare to all of them. See, Jesus, after he said, come out. And even after you're born again, there might be some things that you should be walking in, that you just need an anointing, a hearing, a speaking, a breakthrough, that there would be a loosening of all those things. The Jesus, after he said, come forth, he said, loose him and let. Moses spoke forth to the children of Israel. Joshua brought them out. My God, Jesus carried all of us to victory. All of us to victory, to victory. Hallelujah. And the Holy Spirit is here to bring forth that resurrection. And oh my God, lift up your hands. Say, Father, I thank you that you hear me and that you always hear me. I thank you that you hear what I can't say. Thank you for your perfect will, for salvation, healing, resurrection life. Freedom! I thank you, Father. And today, in the name of Jesus, we command all the opposite of what Jesus did. Everyone who needs salvation, everyone in need of healing, deliverance, freedom, our children, grandchildren, nations, in the name of Jesus, come out, come out, and be loose, 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 in Jesus' name. Hallelujah! 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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. You have to see in the spirit. I see some bowls of chains being broken. See, sometimes some people that are bound and some people that are in the wrong place, sometimes it's because they need to be reminded and hear that that's not who they are anymore. That's not who they are anymore. There's a lot of people that have come out that are born again, but they're hearing the wrong thing. It's up to us to preach the kingdom, to preach the gospel, to preach the way, the truth, and the life. It's up to us, but it's not just our children and grandchildren and other people. It's also all of us today that need to be walking into another level of understanding, of understanding who our Father is. The fact that he hears us is really two ways. He also hears things. You mean you always hear? I always hear. Even when you forget I'm there, I hear. Even when you say things like, oh, I'm so scared what's going to happen in the world, I'm here. Even when I hear you say, oh my, I don't know what we're going to do, I hear you. Even when I hear you say, well, God should have moved already, well, I hear you. I hear when you're impatient. I hear when you grumbling. I hear when you forget that your faith overcomes the world. I hear. But the Lord says, but I don't turn away from you. I hear. And my hearing is not just a hearing. I cannot hear and not do. I hear and I do. And I remove everything that's in the way so that you can walk in the victory that I have purchased for you on Calvary. And God, Father, he wants us to just be so, so excited about the things that he has for us. Because you know, not only we are more than overcomers, but everything that's going to happen in the world is just something that's going to bring forth a manifestation of the glory of God all over the world, all over the world. I said all over the world. The glory of God's going to be seen. It's going to be manifested. God's going to be glorified. And he's not going to do it outside of you. You are the body of Christ. He's going to bring forth his glory in and through you. Hallelujah. So just think what he already has done. And thank him because when you hear him, hear you. It's not waiting for him to do something that he hasn't done. You're thanking him. I thank you that you have heard me. I thank you that you have heard me. There's a wave in this house this morning of a prayer of thanksgiving that's going to open doors, that's going to remove every hindrances that's in your way. Father hears you, and I want us to just bring forth a prayer of thanksgiving to our Father who has heard us. In and through Jesus, he brought forth the victory. So I want you to tell him, thank you, Lord.